We decided that we're going to have a butchering night tonight with our quail. It's nice and cool. It's about 60 degrees. So let me show you what we do. So the first thing that I do is I catch the quail and I use my butterfly net to do that. I don't like my birds to stress. One of the important things to me that I decided when we first got quail was that I would hatch them, I would raise them, I would love them, I would feed them well from our garden, I would give them organic food so that their life with us was well lived before we butchered them for either our dog's food or our food. And so that has always been my promise to them. So even up to the very end, we do everything as humanely as possible. A butterfly net is awesome because I can catch them. They don't stress. I don't have to chase them around. I have my catch box that I will fill with mostly males tonight, and I have my butterfly net to catch them. So let me show you what this might look like. Mama Beats and I will take them over to the butchering area we have that my husband is setting up right now. We have all of our quail in the catch box right here. We have the cutting board. We have the can with a plastic bag in it where all of the organs we don't keep and the head goes in there. We have a variety of scissors and a knife, and we make sure everything is super, super sharp. If there's one super humane thing you do, you make sure everything that you have is super sharp, so everything is very quick and pain-free. We have cutting mats as well. These are from Pampered Chef, and I'll tell you, they are awesome. We have gloves because we're working with quite a bit of bird, and that actually saves the hands. We have another dispatch bucket for any organs that we may have missed the first time. And then we have iced bowls. This one right here will be for heart, kidney, liver, and gizzards if the gizzards are in good shape. This one is for the quail feet, and this one is for the quail carcass. And then I have this entire table where I take the feathers off because I do save the feathers and make feather wreaths. So this whole space will remain clean for getting feathers off in good condition. And then we have plastic bags where we put the carcasses, about 6 to 10 carcasses per bag, and then they go into the freezer. This is the bag where I put all of the feathers, collecting feathers, in case we have to rinse something off. Or one of the carcasses may have something in it that we don't want. And so we always have water running to keep everything as clean as possible. When we're butchering a large number of quail, I will use my portable tractor. And we have that here, and we'll usually fill it. And it takes us about 3 days to butcher all the quail that are in there. But they have beautiful new grass that they can munch on. They have fresh air, shade, sunshine, everything they need. But it's pretty nice, and we do everything right here in our garden. And it's a really, really nice place to do this, and we're close to our quail huts as well. So my husband does the actual killing or culling of our quail. And then I'm on the processing end of the table with the organs, the feet, and the feathers. So when you hold the quail, you want to hold them chest up. And my husband usually strokes them and pets them to help them calm. And we're not actually going to show you the removal of the head part just because it attracts some weirdness on YouTube. But we will show you the process after. So this is how you hold the birds, is chest side up. And then once the head is removed, my husband will hold the quail upside down to let them bleed out. And there really isn't the amount of blood that you normally would see with a chicken. And you'll see the body twitch like that. That's a normal nerve response. And that usually lasts for about a minute, maybe a little bit less. And so he'll hold the birds until the twitching stops. And then he'll cut off the feet and the wings. And the feet we reserve for our dogs. I'll rinse those off really good. And then that it goes into part of their raw meal. And then the wings come off, and the flight feathers I do save, as well as the chest and the back feathers. And we try to not get any of the feathers bloody. And if they do get bloody, I just don't save them.
A little bit on that one, but you have some long feathers.
Okay. And then it's up to me to start pulling out these beautiful feathers that I save for wreath work. And then while I'm doing that, my husband will continue to get the birds out and get them ready. And then why don't you go ahead with this one and show how you take the skin off. And so it actually pulls straight down on the chest side, and it comes off in a pelt straight off. And then we cut the bird straight up the middle. You can see all the beautiful organs. Let's get a good shot of that right there. Hold on just a sec. All the beautiful organs. And then what we'll do is we'll take the intestines and the stomach out, and we save the heart, the liver, and the kidneys. And that also goes into our dog's raw meals.
It's the gizzard.
And the gizzard as well. And so these are the organs we'll be saving. And then the other organs go into the plastic lined bucket. And then the carcasses go on ice until we can get them nice and cold. What you don't want to do is put a carcass in a bag in the freezer, because their body temperature is so warm, it actually can take a day or two for it to freeze. And I just want you to see how gorgeous these feathers are. They're absolutely spectacular. And so to me, it would be a waste to not use these. and make every use possible from the life of this bird.
Are you cutting the wings off as well?
See, you can see these gorgeous feathers. And so now we're well into it, and you can see the carcasses cooling off in the ice. And let me move this, and our organ meats. And then our feet, we've created a pile here because we do have to rinse them first before we put them on ice. We generally have about 1 to 2 people who will stop by to either observe or help out on butchering nights. A lot of people actually want to learn this skill and how to do it. It's really great if you're planning a regenerative farm or a farm with a sustainable meat source. And it's always good to learn new skills, period, and we love the company.
Well, I thought I would be really like horrified by just the whole process, but it doesn't really give me that feeling. It doesn't really give me that sense. It's just more of learning like where like food is actually coming from. It's actually a really cool thing.
There's 9 carcasses in this bag right here. These are actually quite big pops. These are a nice size. Yeah.